Hello and welcome to ExpertMet Video. Today we are joined by Dr. Kirsten Ritter. Dr. Kirsten Ritter is a junior professor for computational neuroscience at the Department of Psychiatry and Psychotherapy at Charité University of Medicine Berlin and leads the research group Machine Learning in Clinical Neuroimaging. She is trained as a mathematician and did her PhD at the Bernstein Center for Computational Neuroscience. Recently, she has been working on the project Deep Learning for Neuroimaging-Based Disease Decoding. Can you please start by telling us something about your background?
I studied mathematics. I did then a PhD in computational neuroscience, did then a postdoc at the Berlin Center for Advanced Neuroimaging, and I'm mostly interested in machine learning methods applied to neuroimaging data, trying to diagnose or characterize neurological or psychiatric diseases.
And so you will be at ExpertMet 2019 in October. What do you plan to talk about?
I will specifically talk about machine learning techniques applied to neuroimaging data in order to diagnose neurological or psychiatric diseases. And more specifically, I'm going to talk about the black box problem of machine learning algorithms and how to build transparent deep learning frameworks. So on the one hand, I'm very interested in mathematical methods and machine learning algorithms. And on the other hand, I'm very fascinated by the brain and structural and functional alterations in neurological or psychiatric diseases. And this topic perfectly combines my interests here. And I also see a very great potential in machine learning algorithms applied to neuroimaging data. So it's
good. So for the average person, as you say, it's a very complex topic. How can one communicate the application of these methods to, in layman's terms?
So trying to better and earlier diagnose neurological or psychiatric diseases based on imaging data, but also based on other data. And we mostly work on multiple sclerosis and Alzheimer's disease, but also, for example, on depression and other kinds of data.
And so how has this topic gained attention in the last few years, and how do you see it developing in the future?
So artificial intelligence and machine learning and deep learning has gained a lot of attention, and the expectations are very high for transforming the field, the medical imaging field. And I also see a very great potential here, but I also see a number of challenges. So the first one is how to get enough and good quality data to exploit the full potential of deep learning algorithms. So this is really difficult, especially in Germany. And second, how to build transferable models. So if you train a model on some kind of data, how to transfer it to other kinds of data. And third, the black box problem, on which I'm also working on.
So circling back to the first problem, in Germany, people are naturally skeptical of data collection and their information being used. How do you change the culture?
So it's difficult for a person alone to change the culture. I'm trying to talk to a lot of people. So I'm at Charité University Hospital, which is the largest university hospital in Germany and even in Europe. And there are a number of people who are very interested in this topic, and we're trying to build like groups and trying to convince people how important it is and how everyone can profit from these algorithms.
And so ExpertMet will be an international festival, and we're bringing people from different ecosystems from across the globe. Are there any in particular that you're interested in and could be used as a potential model for the German healthcare system?
This is also a very difficult question. Of course, for example, China, they have less strict data policies, so they can generate larger data sets, which is very useful for the field. But I would not say that they are a role model here. I think we need to find our own ways to establish this culture here.
You will be an expert, of course. What do you hope to take back from the festival?
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to a number of inspiring talks and to fruitful discussions with other researchers and policymakers, and I hope to make up some collaborations.
Yes. And Charité is a partner, a medical partner of the ExpertMet. How do you see this partnership working in the future and developing?
I think this could be a very fruitful partnership. I think it's very important for Charité to be present on this kind of events.
And so you have a very interesting journey as a researcher. Do you have any words of encouragement to any young researchers out there who are just starting out and are looking for inspiration?
Yes, so I'm not settled, so I'm still in the qualification phase, so it's difficult to give any strict recommendations. I think it's very important to focus on a relevant research area. I think it's very good to use computational models in whatever you're doing, and I think it's very important to stay open and, but also to persistently work on your research questions and also, also acknowledge the small steps you're making.
Okay, and finally, do you have any words to the XMET community at large?
Thank you very much for organizing this event. I'm very looking forward to this. It's my first time there.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.